Hi, this is Paul Thomas at Interfex 2011, talking today with Jim Cannon of METTLER TOLEDO Thornton. Jim, thanks for being with us.
Paul, thank you for having us. Looking forward to talking to you.
One of the things we talked about a little earlier was digital conductivity. Can you talk a little bit about more what that is and why it's so important?
Yes, and I'd like to talk about digital. I'd like to move over to our transmitters here. Thornton, we have introduced what we refer to as UniCond, which is a trade name for Thornton. UniCond stands for Universal Conductivity, and we've brought digital conductivity, and by digital conductivity, we've eliminated the analog problems. Now, digital conductivity, we take an analog signal from the sensor, convert it to digital, all right, and it's transmitted to our transmitter. What's the benefit? Well, the benefit is you eliminate all the analog capacitance problems that are caused by cables, analog cables. You also eliminate what's called polarization error. Now, polarization error limited previously a sensor to only be measured, say, in the pure, ultra-pure water range. Now, with UniCond, we can measure from ultra-pure water to seawater with a 33% increase in accuracy. Now, you combine UniCond technology, which we call ISM, Intelligent Sensor Management. Now, Intelligent Sensor Management is an expansion of Thornton's smart technology, which we introduced in the 90s. Well, ISM, we've brought is a pH, dissolved oxygen, ozone, and you combine it with something like our new M800 platform, which is a touchscreen display that allows you to actually monitor the life of the sensor. All the sensors are pre-calibrated, but now with digital, we can store actually the calibration date in the head of the sensor, the part number, the serial number. It talks to the meter. So you have a true plug-and-measure technology here. You plug it in, you're ready to go. You can look up the calibration date for the sensor, its part number, its serial number. You can look up how many cycles it has gone in a clean-in-place process, how many cycles till maintenance. And this time to maintenance, this can save a customer a lot of money. It can save them downtime because this allows them to actually maintain when the sensor needs maintenance, not just do it on a predictive scale, do it when it needs the maintenance.
So obviously, as a preventive maintenance tool, this is something that anybody should be interested in.
It's hugely valuable to the pharmaceutical industry because it can make sure, one, it can save them money, it reduces downtime, which saves them costs, and it can prevent excursions that can be a regulatory problem for them.
And as you said, it's 33% more accurate than previously. What does that really mean in terms of the importance?
Today, you know, the pharmacopoeias all have a certain accuracy requirement that they have to meet. And in pharmaceutical, you must calibrate. You have to. Now, the pharmacopoeia does not tell you how often, but they tell you you must calibrate. So with this improved accuracy, first of all, you know you have the most accurate sensor available in the world today. Previously, you had an error factor. You had a transmitter error factor. You had a cable error factor. You had an error factor for the sensor. Now, because of the digital technology, those have been eliminated. So you've got this 33% increase in accuracy, and you have, knowing that when this sensor was calibrated, you don't have to guess. Did somebody lose the paperwork when it was calibrated? You can always look it up.
Of course, your PAT programs will work a lot better if there's not a lot of guessing involved. So
always, that's always the truth. Thank you.
Jim, thanks for being with us. Really appreciate it.
Paul, thank you very much for your time.